Hello everybody! In this video I will explain you what is a scanner room, how to use it and where you have to go in order to get the blueprint required to build one. Back to the topic, in order to build one you need to discover the blueprint in special location I will show later in this video. Anyway, once you get it, you will need 5 titanium, 2 copper ore, 1 gold and 1 table coral sapple to build one of these structures. The scanner room is a special base building compartment that allows you to search the area for specific location or resources that you can select from the list you can find inside the room. Once selected, the structure will start to scan the surroundings, showing upside the hologram in the middle of the room the location of the chosen items. In order to find them easier, the scanner room comes with 2 camera robots that you can control from the other panel on the left respect to the previous one. Once interacted with it, you will start to control one of the camera that you can switch using the interaction button displayed in the bottom. These cameras can see the location of the desired items displayed with an orange circle around them. To be able to collect it, move the camera to its location. Then get out from the camera control and start searching for your camera. That will be enough easy because these machines has an internal beacon in them that you can enable, disable and change colors that will allow you to find them easy. This will lead you to find also the item near where you left it. To optimize the process, you can craft more camera drones that you can build from the special fabricator you can find inside the scanner room. In order to be able to make one, you need a computer chip, a battery, a glass and a titanium. The chip and the battery can be crafted from the normal fabricator. If you still have problems to farm the ingredients to make them, check the basics playlist. Anyway, once you build more drones, just get outside of the base and drop them. Now that you did so, they will be automatically connected to the scanner room control panel. Around the initial zone is slightly problematic to use these cameras anyway. This is because of the stalker creatures that like to eat metal. This means that if you leave some cameras near their territory, they will grab them and bring them all over the place, decreasing its efficiency to help you find resources. In case this will happen, they can be slightly damaged, so sometimes you have to repair them using the repair laser. Also, if you will use them enough often, you have also sometimes to bring them to the scanner room in a specific slot in order to recharge their batteries. A small trick, early game you can use the camera to search some hit zone that usually inside has a lot of resources that will be enough to get started. Also to find special structures like wrecks if you struggle to use coordinates to find them. Also once finished to farm you have to disable the camera beacon's visibility from your PDA in order to avoid having too much signals in the screen while exploring. Over time, you will start to explore other places where you will be able to find special resources. One of these that you will need for your scanner room is the magnetite you can easily find in the jelly shroom cave. If you want to know more about this place, check the first farming base tutorial that shows how enter inside the special location, what you can farm in it and how to set up a farming base in it. Anyway, once you get your first magnetite, you will be able to craft a hood chip that can be equipped in order to see the scanner room signals without using camera drones. That will allow you to farm a lot easier, faster and without dealing with stalker creatures. But there is a small problem. If you have 2 scanner rooms and in both is enabled the scanning, you will see both signals with the same hood chip. That can be a problem, so don't forget to disable the scanning after you leave the farming zone. Also, when you get this chip, don't forget to collect all cameras and put them away in a locker. In order to decrease the confusion you can have in the PDA data when you're searching for specific beacon. This special material also allows you to craft an upgrade for your scanning that will increase its range. While before get the magnetite, you can build only the upgrade for the scan speed that require 1 gold and 1 silver to build. Now that you know all you need about this structure, it's time to discuss where you can find the blueprints to build one. All locations I will show are large racks you can find on specific coordinates I will display. So, if you still didn't know how to use coordinates, check the respective video about this topic linked in the description. Also, in these locations you can find different blueprints that change how in location, how in type and quantity. This also means that in some cases you didn't find it at first try. This is why I show all the locations you can find them. The first location is a rack with coordinates are displayed right now. Once here, you can find the scanner room fragments outside of the main structure. Out there you can find also some CMOF and battery chargers blueprints. While to explore the inside part, it is secondary because you can't find the scanner room fragments in it. But you can find a lot of laser cutter that you will need to explore the inner part of other racks. In fact, if you want to learn more about this tool, check the respective video in the description. Back to the scanner room, the second location is another rack on the displayed coordinates. Around this structure, usually there are a lot of bioreactor and scanner room fragments, in particular under the big part of the wreckage beside the sand that creates a covered room. But be careful, inside here there are also two tiger plants that will attack you once you get too close. How for the previous exploration, for the initial part is secondary if you're searching only the scanner room blueprints. Another rack that have the blueprint you're searching for, which coordinates are seen right now, usually outside has also some bioreactor and mobile vehicle bay fragments. Then the fourth and the last easy rack location is displayed right now. Outside here you can find not only the scanner room fragments but also some laser cutter as well. Next, the next three locations are below 200 meters in deep, so you can't get easy here without the CMOF depth module. If you want to know more about it, check the CMOF videos linked in the description. But in the first, which coordinate you see right now, you can find outside a lot of special blueprints like moon pool, prone suit drill arm, prone suit grappling arm, thermal plant and cyclopus depth module. The next rack is one that I didn't recommend to explore because it has a low amount of blueprints outside despite the special loot inside, but for which you will need a laser cutter. Without speaking about the tons of aggressive fauna all around the place. While the last location where you can find the scanner room, that also is a dangerous because of aggressive fauna. Besides the scanner room fragments, have also outside the special alien containment blueprint that will allow you to hatch eggs and grow fauna and flora inside a huge aquarium you can place in your base. About this special structure you will find a dedicated playlist about all you need to know about it and anything you can grow inside. Back to the rack, to access the internal part you need to use the laser cutter to open the way in, where you will find the special water filtration machine and some other minor blueprints. For the filtration machine you will be able to use it in order to generate a lot of purified water that you will be able to refill this statistic like nothing, considering that it generates passively water bottles that restore 50% of the statistic at a time. Without speaking about the salts that can be processed with some coral tube samples in two bottles that restore 30% each. But this structure can be placed only in a multi-purpose room. So, if you still didn't find it, check the respective video linked in the description. Now that you get all you need, you are ready to start farming anything you need really easy thanks to the scanner room.